coach 1 month into the season, you know, starting that last stretch before conference play, you know, where do you see your team? Do you like where your team's at as we head into the month of December?
Well, it's been a long road. It's been a long travel road for us. We played our first 7 out of 9 games on the road, and we haven't played a Division I opponent at home yet. So we get a chance to sleep in our own beds for 2 or 3 consecutive days, which is good for us. And it showed in our Monday's practice that our guys are a little bit refreshed, and we're rolling into the second half of the non-conference schedule. We played a very difficult schedule with a very travel, hard travel situation. And I thought we played South Carolina. South Carolina probably was the best team we played to this point. And they're 7-0 right now going into Clemson tonight. And then back-to-back against Vanderbilt, another SEC team, which was tough. And then that road trip, you know, for us, we came home and got a little bit of relief against Carolina University. But had a great win at East Carolina. But we probably should have came home and ended the trip there. But going to Minneapolis and then Muncie, Indiana, and, you know, 4 different flights, 4 different hotels, and 3 different cities was just tough for our team. And we just couldn't raise to the level against Ball State. We're figuring out our team, and we're trying to get 8, 9, 10 guys to play together at a high level all the time. And I think that's coming around right now with the emergence of Floyd Radu, where he's playing off the bench has been a high level the last couple of games.
You know, you mentioned the road win at East Carolina. You had another big road win this past weekend at NC Central. What do wins like that and going into enemy territory and picking up a game like that mean going forward for this group?
Well, you know, our goal is to win the Big South Championship, and you can't win that by just winning your home games, and you have to be able to win on the road. And so winning at East Carolina and winning at North Carolina Central was a good deal for us. And I love our first 30 minutes of that game. We were up by 15 points with about 10 minutes to go in that game and just didn't have a good pace of play the last 10 minutes of the game. But it shows the way our program has come to where our guys expect to win those games. I thought we played good enough to win at Coastal, and we just couldn't make enough plays at the end to win that game. But winning road games are crucial for us, but it's great to be back home playing our next 3 out of 4 games.
You know, you mentioned good to win those games on the road. One of the foundations kind of for your program that's helped you win those games over the last couple of years is your team's defense. Tops in the league in steals, led by your preseason All-Big South honoree, Justin Bailey. You know, what does your team's intensity on the defensive end do to help build what you want from this program?
Well, you know, in basketball, I mean, this is not the NBA. You know, you look at those scores last night, someone scored 146 points, and no one is going to do that in college, right? So you have to be able to stop good teams and good players. And we put an emphasis on that every day. And if it's a non-contact practice or contact practice, the biggest emphasis is on our half-court defense. And so Justin has done a good job with his toughness, and he plays every possession the same way, and we love that. And but we got, you know, Trey Broadnex. I think our guards really defend well. Jordan Surratt is probably our best defender, and so Amir is coming around as far as getting more defensive rebounds and getting some block shots at the rim. But our defense is going to be big throughout the season, and especially on Saturday against Kennesaw State.
You know, and your team has turned defense into offense. Trey, Justin leading this team in points, both averaging over 10. But you've got a group of guys there that are in that 6 to 9 point range, Amir Langley, yeah, Floyd Radu, and Miguel Ayesa. What do those guys mean to your team?
Well, one of my coaches told me this morning that Ron said that we are top 30 in the country at converting in fast breaks. And so we've made that an emphasis in practice to where if we are going to get stops, get steals, and be disruptive as a defensive team, we have to really turn that into offense. And so I'm glad to see that's paying off. But our team is a team this year. We don't have one guy that's going to average 17, 18, 19 points a game. We're going to need everybody to pitch in and play well on the offensive end, but especially on the defensive end and rebounding part of it.
Yeah, and you mentioned it right there, Coach. You got, I think it's 6 to 7 guys that are averaging, you know, anywhere from 7 to 12 points, and that balanced offense comes as you're one of the top teams in the league in sharing the basketball as well. Lots of assists from this team.
Yeah.
You know, what does that mean for your offense?
It means everything. You know, there are some things we talk about every day. We talk about defending, rebounding, taking care of the basketball. And before the North Carolina Central game, we really took care of the basketball in those games before that. But the next thing we talk about is being great teammates and being totally unselfish, and that means on the offensive end. And so we have to share the basketball. We have a really good offensive team when we're sharing it. We have guys that can really make shots, and what that does, it's important for two players, for Trey Broadnax and Amir Langley. And since that, Trey can now get those drives that he needs to be successful and help us to close our games. And then we can throw the ball inside to Amir. And so us playing inside-out basketball and playing first and second side and then third side is important for us. And I think our guys are bought into it, but it's a struggle every day. We got to fight it as coaches.
Coach, you mentioned, you know, two players, Amir and Trey, being able to open up the lane for them. And a couple guys that are very crucial to doing that, you know, playing inside out, especially beyond the three-point line. Miguel Iesa, Eddie Placer, George Ochoa, you know, the guys that can knock spot up and knock down that big three-pointer for your team. And that's been very big for this group this year, you know. Where do you see their growth, especially as guys that not a lot of experience coming in, new to the program, and where they're taking this team?
Yeah, I've been very impressed with our returning guys. Justin Bale, I sent him a text last night on him being a playmaker and making good decisions in our offense, and that's been really big for us. But the emergence of our team is going to be Miguel, AEC, and Eddie Placer, and George Ochoa and Pat Ario. We need those guys to keep practicing well so they can play well. And for us, when guys practice well, they normally play well. And we need those guys to keep coming because they're going to be a big part of who we are going forward. And they'll be a big part of who we are and as far as winning the Kennesaw State game.
Yeah, and that group of guys, the ability to hit the three off the bench, also, you know, Floyd and Justin hitting that three. What has the three ball done for your offense this year? As you've hit multiple or double digit threes four times this year. You had only done it 4 times last year. You know, it's become a big part of your team's offense.
You know, 2 years ago, I thought we were a great 3-point shooting team. We had 5 guys in the starting lineup that shot over 35-38% for the 3-point line. And I think this team could be even better. And you have to use the 3-point line as a big part of who you are these days. And I have this saying, nothing changes if nothing changes, and that's on me. I got to change how I think about and approach our team. And the strength of our team right now is the fact that we're sharing the ball at a high rate and we're shooting the ball at a high rate. And so now we got to continue to do that to open up the middle.
You know, now looking ahead, back at home, back at the Hodge, a place that your team has had a lot of success over the last couple of years. Mm-hmm. You know, going into Kennesaw State, what are you seeing and what do you want to see from the home crowd?
Well, we're going to need the home crowd the next couple of weeks. We've got Kennesaw State coming in the next Saturday on the 16th. We play Western Carolina. And when I looked at the small college rankings, those two programs in the top 25. And so we're going to need Spartan Army to come out and support us. Kennesaw State averaged 31 threes a game. They have the best tempo, one of the best tempos in college basketball. They really do a good job of defending your best players. And so for us, you know, we think our team is good. We think our program is good. But our fans have been the most important part of who we are. And so we need our students, we need our followers, we need our supporters to come out because it's going to be a big game for both men and women basketball on the 9th. 1, 2, 3.